Hi everyone, and thank you again for joining to the session. And we'll be getting started now on the session. And over to you, Babiando.
Okay, thank you. I will continue, and maybe I will restart from the definition of Azure App Services. So basically, Azure App Service fully managed platform as a service, so you can just deploy your application to the Azure without manage the server. And Azure App Services supported with some language, for example, .NET, .js, Python, Java, and also Ruby. But currently, I just support Ruby on Rails and also PHP. If you have another or other language, you can deploy with custom container. So basically, you can containerize your application with Docker, and after that, you can deploy into Azure App Services. And Azure App Services have support with Windows and Linux, but not all languages support with Windows. Not all languages supported with Linux. You can see the supported operating system in here in this table. And we move to Azure Static Web Apps. Azure Static Web Apps usually to deploy static content such as HTML, image, JavaScript, and CSS. You can deploy React application or Vue.js and also Angular to Azure Static Web Apps. You also can deploy API to Azure Functions, but it's not mandatory. You can deploy API or just use another API. So basically, Azure Static Web Apps is a service that automatically builds and deploy full stack web apps to Azure from a code repository. You can deploy from GitHub Actions or using Azure DevOps pipelines. For deployment using GitHub Action, you can use Azure Portal or from the GitHub website. I will demo how to create the script. And yeah, you also can see how deployed using .NET, .js, and Python in this link. But I will show you after this slide. Okay, we can move to Portal Azure. Wait, I need to refresh. For Azure App Services, we can use create resource, and after that, go to web app and create. And we can put in them, for example, .NET, example, Perfianto. And for the runtime, we can select .NET 7 for this example. And we can select region. I will choose Sotis Axia and operating system Linux. You need to define the pricing plans. These pricing plans will define your server. For example, for free, it will use free resources and shared infrastructure. But I already create the service plan. And we can next. Because this is a free plan, we cannot setting the deployment in here, but we can setting the deployment after creating the web app. Oh, sorry. Very small, right? I think you can see now. Okay, we can just skip another settings and after that create the web Azure App Service. Okay. Meanwhile, I will explain the static web apps. So as I mentioned before, we can deploy React.js and also React.js with Azure Functions. And you can see the guideline in this link. But I will share with you after this session. Okay, we will back to the demo. So after we created the Azure App Service, we can go to Deployment Center. You can set up GitHub Action in here in Portal Azure. But this is still loading. And for another option, we can set up in here. So we can go to the repository. I have the repository in here. And because I want to deploy .NET Core, so we can select this action. For the deployment, we need web name, which is .NET example Virtento in here. And for the packet path, I will show you my code first. Okay, to zoom in. Okay. My application in here. So my application in App Service and in C# folder. So I need to define it. We need to define the working directory in GitHub Action. This is uncommon pipeline because I have many applications in one repository, but usually you only have one application in one repository. You can use this one in our job. And we can use the app service C sharp as a working directory. Usually in CI/CD, we need to deploy, we need to build and publish the application first before we deploy the application. Okay. After that, we need this one, the secrets, the published profile. We can get the published profile from Diploma Center. You can get in here, GitHub. Wait. Oh, this one. And this profile. You can download the published profile. And save it in here. And we can copy the value of the published profile to the secret. We can setting the secret in here, settings, and go to secrets actions. We can add new repository secret. Copy the value in here. And copy the key to the name. And we need to setting up this one. I think it's okay. Yeah, after we finish setting the configuration, we can commit the change. But for this example, I will select different branch. For example, .NET. Wait. But usually, you can setting the GitHub action in Portal Azure. Wait, I need to close it. Okay. You need to connect your Azure account with GitHub account, and after that, you need to sign in here. I already sign in here, and you can choose the organization. And you also choose the repository. But I think my repository not shown in here. For example, this one, and we can choose branch main, and the Portal Azure will generate the script. But mostly it will be it will be the same with this template. Okay. And then I think we can try to deploy. Wait, should be in action. Oh no. I do change .NET 1. Oh, I need to change the notification and also the prints. Because we use the red one, we can use the red one. And the deployment process will restart. Oh. Wait, I think the version is wrong. X. Basically, it's not limited to ASP.NET. We can deploy another language. I have the I have Python code in here also. Python in here. This is Django framework. And we can deploy using with this one. Deploy Python app to an Azure web app. We can try to configure. But we need to create the Azure web app first in Portal Azure. Can to go in dashboard. And after that, create resource. And also create. For example, Python. And we can select the Python version. For example, Python 3.8. And we select the region. As we can see, for the Python, only support Linux. And anyway, for the free version, we only limited to create maybe 5 application or 3 application. Okay, I think I will next to Azure Static Web App. You can just create a web app, same with the Azure Web Azure App Service, but the different you can use static prevent. And we choose static web app. And it will redirect us to the recent page, create static web app. And the static. And we can choose the region, for example, is Asia. And we can choose the source. If you want from GitHub, we can choose GitHub. And if you want from Azure DevOps, we can also choose Azure DevOps. And also choose another options. Can check, you can choose organization, and after that, choose the repository. For example, I will build the React application. We can choose the framework. Because this is React application, we choose React. Because we don't have as a function, we can let this field blank. And after that, you can just create. And after that, create. Okay, I think we can see the previous job in here, actions. As you can see, it's already deployed, and we can click this link to show our application. We can associate our application in Portal Azure. Because this is a free version, sometimes it's really take a long time to see. And this is for the static web app. For the Azure static web app, usually it will automatically add the GitHub action script in here. As we can see, it is already run. And wait. This is from .NET application. So for the root, just show hello world. Okay. And for the Azure Static Web Apps, it only have one job, and basically it will build the React application and deploy the the file into Azure Static Web Apps. Anyway, do you have any question? If you want to explore more about the automated deployment, I already add Notion. I will copy in here. So feel free to explore more for other language, for example, Java or Ruby or PHP. You can see in my website. Seems like failed. Oh, I think fell from my code. It's okay. So, do you have any question? I think I'm already finished now. Feel free to ask if you have any question.
Thank you, Bhavyendra, for the session. For attendees, if you have any questions, and please to type it up in the chat box, and let's give them 1 to 2 minutes so that they can just type up in the chat box.
So no
there anybody with a question? Can get here 1 minute so that I have enough time and type it up. Shared shortly after the Q&A session. I guess it was clear to everybody here and they're not having any doubts, no doubts at all, I guess.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's all from me. If you have any question, you can contact me in LinkedIn, Virgentoli Pratama. I think so, probably.
If there is anybody who is, you know, getting a question just after the session is concluded, you can go go to his LinkedIn and ping him. If there is, you know, he'll be able to help you with the further clearance. And Vivian, if you can join our community, that'd be great, so that they can, you know, ask it themselves.
I think I have joined the Azure APSE discussion.
If there is nothing left, okay. See no more question. Okay, thank you, Viviando, again for the session. It was resourceful, even though we had some technical issues in the middle. But yeah, I hope you the attendees were able to, you know, learn, and they will be able to apply this in their work or their, you know, projects. Okay, thank you all for joining, and thank you again for Viviando, and thank you for joining, and have a great rest of the day.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.